Hi Elaine, this is Andrew of NJ Mac Magic. I know that we've gone through quite a few things in trying to resolve your extremely slow internet connection. Initially we thought it was the new router having issues. I actually believe it's your system configuration and the way that your computer is trying to, your MacBook Pro, is trying to contact the internet or the DNS servers. So what I'm going to do is get you to flush out your computer network settings. And it's done quite simple. So before you do anything, I want you to go up into the wireless signal indicator in the top right-hand corner of your screen, further up in this corner. And I want you to switch off your airport. Just switch off the signal so you have no bars. Okay, so once you've done that, I want you then to open up your and make sure that you've kind of, it's probably best to quit out of all programs at this point, just so you don't mess anything else up. And then what I want you to do is to open up your Macintosh hard drive, and then from there I want you to open up your library. So you got your Macintosh hard drive, library, preferences, system configuration, and from there you should have a bunch of files that look like this. What I need you to do is click on the airport, click on the network identification, click on the network interfaces and the preferences. Some people might think this is overkill, but at least you're starting afresh if you do so. So with that being done, just if you hold down or right click, if you have a right click mouse, hold down the control key and click with your regular mouse and then just move to trash. What I have done, in fact, before I do that, what I have done is I've created a folder on my desktop and I've dragged these files to that folder to make a copy of them for, you know, if all else fails, at least you'll be able to drag them back and replace those files. So then hold down control, click on these files and move to trash. It will ask for your password. And they're in the trash. Now you can close this window. And now I want you to open up your system preferences for the first time. Now open up network. As you can see, there's nothing in here, which is absolutely fine. Click on the plus button. I'm sorry. Edit locations. Click on the plus button, type in automatic, click done, and then let's see, down here, click on the airport, and then here, turn airport on. Do that. A list of networks that are available will propagate this field. Choose your network, and you may or may not have to put in your password for the wireless signal, for the wireless router's password settings that I left you with, or that actually was left there previously. Hit apply. Waiting for the system to propagate itself with the settings. Okay. Now we want airport at the top, so that's its first, because I have other services set up on this system, not necessarily for the internet. This computer is just like yours and it is wired to access the internet presently through my airport So what I want to do is click on this little cog setting here, and then you want to go to set service order. Well, as you have here, your airport presently is your fastest connection to the internet. After that, you have Ethernet. So what I'm going to do, actually, I'm sorry, Ethernet is way faster than airport, so drag that to the top. So when that your laptop is plugged in, hardwired, it will supersede airport. And then I'll do these, which is fine. And then, so it's Ethernet, then airport. Don't worry about anything else. And then just click OK. And as you can see, my airport went to the very top. I have an IP address designated by the router, 192.168.1.4. Yours more than likely will be different. Then click on the advanced. TCP/IP. You're okay. Make sure that you're connected using DHCP. There's my router address, which is of no use to anyone because that's just the internal router address. And if you want, just for giggles, you can renew the DHCP lease. Go to DNS. Here you have your router. It's 192.168.1.1. I believe that your router is also the same address, though it might not be. This is where the mess up might be happening on your system. Go to DNS. Make sure, let me know if this DNS server has self-propagated with an address. You will not be able to take it away, but you will be able to add more. So don't do anything at that point. Just contact me and let me know what address you have here. The next thing, you're not really on a network so that others may find you to share files and what have you. I am, so I'm going to turn this on. Make our Apple Talk active. You can leave yours off or on. It really doesn't matter. It only helps when I actually come to visit you. And I'm going to click OK. And actually, I'm just going to go back in to the advanced button here. And I'm going to check 802. All right, there's nothing there. Proxies manually, there should be nothing here, none of this should be activated, and then Ethernet, that's all automatic, and that's perfect. Okay, click OK, then apply. Click apply. It's grayed out. My system settings are set. Now I'm just going to test the network.